Okay, we are back in Tales Symphonia. And before we get started, there's something I looked into off-camera. So, the Spirit Ring, you'll notice, recovers 1% of max TP at fixed rate during battle. If you rune bottle this, then it turns into a Holy Ring, and vice versa. So if you want the bigger heals, be it HP or TP, it actually requires a different item altogether. Anyway, we successfully snuck into Meltopia in the previous section, Crin and Danger. On this side, you might summon spirits into research subjects as well, correct? Yes, in order to use mana as energy, it's most efficient to study the summon spirits themselves. Fascinating. In what way are these entities known as summon spirits created, and what effect do they have on the world? I oppose summon spirit research. Oh? Why? Just do. Crin suffered painful experiences during the experimental stage. That's right, Crin is a man-made summon spirit. Fascinating. Uh-oh. Run for it! Come back here this instant! So I haven't been over here. Just missed all right before you to the church. Well, at least he was kind enough to ask first. Seems Fable Knights are pursuing the Chosen, but we trust you. Hello, my beloved. Hello. Dark Bottle. Hello, Beauty. Chosen one, skin line. This guy has a massive nose, damn. Hello, madam. Chosen, would you become my pet in place of my kitten? Wow. I think the homeless girl had more money than her, which is really, really messed up. The house will be under my care until Master Zetlos returns. He's right here. And you can see all the presents lined up on the table. Nothing here. More presents. I thought you could rest at his house, but oh well. Let me just make sure there isn't a wonder Yes, there is. I am the mysterious gourmet, the Wonder Chef. I shall teach you the recipe for that essential party food, the fruit cocktail. Fruit cocktail requires any two fruits you like. Farewell. So at this point of the game, the recipe should be getting more potent. And we still only recover small amounts. Almost have half the recipes. Anyway, let's peek into the other houses if possible. No better way to start a video off than random looting, after all. Father's a famous musician. Why is she not giving me goodies? What gives one? Okay, this is where you find some other costumes. Namely, the fancy dress-up ones. So that kind of concludes our business over there. Now I know where Sheena's people are offhand. Better avoid the castle. That's right, they said the research lab. Oh man, that one actually looks better. They won't let me examine it. Hmm. Didn't I talk to them before, or can you do it multiple times? Oh, okay. Huh. I'm kinda confused. Anyway, we need to find the research lab. Okay, I think I know where it is. Process elimination means it's over here by the inn. We have to head up. Has to be this way. First, let me... Huh. So I guess you can talk to them multiple times. That I did not know. Sheena, it's you. Kuchinawa, why are you here? I'm on a top secret mission. What about you? I'm in a bit of trouble, actually. My friends and I need to get across the bridge. Friends. They're not from Mizuho. They're from Silverhunt. Lloyd, everyone, this is a friend from Mizuho. His name's Kuchinawa. She and I grew up together. Pleased to meet you. Pleased to meet you. I'll go talk to the people in the laboratory. Let's go along and listen to. That's insane! What's wrong? Listen to this. They want us to cross the sea in an elemental cargo. An ele what? Elemental cargo, typically called EC. It's a compact transport vehicle controlled by X-spheres. Its maximum load weight is 1,400 kilograms, and maximum speed is more than 3 times faster than an upgraded X-sphere-equipped carriage. They are currently used primarily by shipping companies for delivery services. Hey, what are we, packages? The elemental cargo absorbs mana from the atmosphere and ejects it into the air, producing a counter-reaction that propels it forward. So, if we use Undine for that, we can get an EC that can surf. Surf? Isn't there any other way? The bridge is closed. You don't have the necessary identification to use an ocean liner. On top of that, there are 2 half-elves with you. Not that again. That's the kind of world Tethiala is. We too hardly ever get to leave this building. I wonder why everyone can't get along. Well, there's no point in getting all gloomy. So will you make a modified EC for us? If you'll wait a day, we'll have it ready. Okay then, let's go rest in my mansion. The Pope's minions aren't going to be waiting for us there, right? We're going to have to spend the night in this city, so it doesn't matter where we are, it'll still be dangerous. I guess you're right. My mansion's in the Noble's Quarter, to the right of Castle Tethiala. It's a conspicuously big building, so you can't miss it. Hello, my beloved. You know I'm a half-elf, right? Okay, these corridors are just way too narrow. I miss you, honey. The Chosen One spoke to me. Nothing over there. So, yeah, let's head to Zelos' pad. Those, and I just realized I missed the old lady. Squid. Not gonna make any jokes. Not a one. What was this place, if I remember correctly? Welcome home, Chosen One. Yo, I'm back. Anything happen while I was gone? I was instructed by the Pope and an emissary of His Majesty to the Isle of the 18th to report as soon as the Chosen returned. You can just ignore that. Yes, sir. Ah, and who's the guest with the 2 swords? My bud. Just make yourselves at home. If you need anything... if there's anything you need, sir bud, please speak to me. my name's not Bud. Well, who knows, Lloyd? Maybe he'll catch on. It smells nice. Oh, is it weird for me to be looking at flowers? You said this fireplace ignites by one touch. What's one touch? Mylene Wilder. It seems this is a portrait of Zealous's mother. These presents are tributes from my honeys. Oh, it's so hard being popular. We may be retiring to bed now. We still have to talk to Sheena and Presea. Presea, You're pretty. What is that? I'm complimenting you. I see, and you are pretty too. And there you have it. So let's go hit the hay before it gets any more awkward than it already friggin' is. Okay then, let's go to the Elemental Research Laboratory. Clint, what's wrong? I think I slept wrong. My shoulder feels stiff. Are you alright? Sorry. Now, since it's a new day, nothing we can do. Luckily, this time I remember where the place is. Probably should switch to Lloyd and over to his personal skills so I can run around town a bit more quickly. Welcome back. Everything's ready. Where's the EC? Kuchinawa carried it away already. Kuchinawa got it? What? I thought Kuchinawa had talked to you about it, but I guess he didn't. Go to the artificial beach on the right side of the Grand Tethyala Bridge. Kuchinawa should be waiting there. Also, take this with you. What's this? What do you mean, what's this? It's a wing pack. You store the EC in it. And this? Is the elemental cargo that small? I see. They don't have wing packs in Silverant. Man, you guys are a bunch of country folk. Gee, sorry. Don't get mad now. I'll show you how to use it later. Come on, let's get going. Wait, is it just a second? Come on out, Corin. Gone for a while. Say goodbye to everyone. It's all right. They aren't going to do any more weird experiments on you. Corin, how have you been? Look after Sheena for us. I hate this place. I have Sheena, so I won't be lonely. Corin, don't talk like that. Goodbye. I guess Corin still hates us. Now the question is, can I get out the front door, or do I have to go deal with that whole sewer nonsense again? Oh, that's right, they do let you skip, if I remember correctly. EC. Man, I can't wait to board the EC. Lloyd sure is carefree about this. No kidding. It's ridiculous they were going to be riding over the ocean something that was designed as a land vehicle. You think so? It sounds a lot more reliable than those washtubs. Washtubs? No way! Don't tell me you Don't tell me that in Silverant you crossed the ocean on washtubs. Just thinking about those washtubs is making me sick. So don't you kind of wish Zealous could paint a picture of what he thinks Silverant is like? Right there's the quick jump. I remember that was in the GameCube version. Although I definitely could use the EXP. Gonna see how much longer I can go before I actually have to sit down and grind. So by artificial beach, I believe they mean this little dock thing. Maybe not. Thank you. I just noticed my party had been rearranged on me. I'm gonna bench Rain for a little bit while I continue working on Sheena and Zelos. Kuchino should be waiting for us at the bottom of the right staircase. Okay, then let's go. It's locked. Alright, I'll take care of it. There we go. Wow, Lloyd, you're amazing. At least he's useful for certain things. His face was out to mine, though. What has my face got to do with anything? See the bridge. You're right. Are those decoration-looking things X-spheres? That's right, Clint. That bridge is operated by X-spheres. It's a bit gross-looking. Yeah, it certainly is grotesque. Although, knowing where X-spheres come from, I'm not sure it's appropriate to describe them that way. You're right. Took you long enough. This is the EC. Okay, Lloyd, try using that pack you just got. Let's see, like this? Whoa. Wow, that's incredible. Wow, how does it work? Why do I feel like I've seen this before? Nothing. See, it fits inside. It disappeared. It's amazing. This is so cool. Let's try bringing it back out. It came back out. Wow. That's enough goofing around. How about getting on your way? Yeah. Alright, I can't wait to make use of this EC. This is great. You know, you'll just get bored with it in no time. We get to go out to sea. Going to sea, aren't we? Let's get going then. Off to Cybok. Sheena, take this with you. A protective charm. Yes, be careful. Undine. Got our new ride. You boarded from the piers. A to move forward. Bumpers to rotate camera. B to disembark. Now, unfortunately, I don't believe you can pass underneath here. So you have to take the long way around or do something. It gets better once you can finally fly. Yeah, that's right, I never went after the monument yet. We'll worry about that in a second. Cybok first.
Kratos! Are you trying to take Colette away?
And he's back in his old gear.
I have no intention of fighting you inside the city. You still lack the skills to defeat me.
Don't insult me!
I merely speak the truth. Chosen One, if you wish to live, you must remove that worthless key crest.
No, I'm never taking it off. Lloyd gave this to me.
Foolish sentiments.
He wasn't after Colette?
Man, what an arrogant SOB. Talking as if he knows everything.
While we're on the subject of ways of talking, why don't you do something about the vulgar language? Anyway,
Lloyd, we must go see this Kate person.
Yeah, let's get going.
Peach. Pineapple gel, that is pretty nice. Now, unfortunately, I don't remember what planet the cat's village is on. Well, I'm getting some fruit for that cocktail. It's going through the secret passage. It's you. We saved our friends and came back with Presea, just like we promised. Yes, you're right. The strange mana produced by the fusion of elven and human blood. You really do have half-elf friends. I've heard the story. Presea's creating a Crucius crystal inside her body? Yes, that's correct. We call it the Angelus Project. The Angelus Project? That's the project my mom was involved in. The X-Sphere itself is nothing special. It just has a special key crest placed on it. This key crest delays the X-Sphere's parasitic process, which can take place over a few days or up to several decades. It seems this can cause the X-Sphere to mutate into Crucius crystals. Is the parasitic infection of the X-Sphere the reason why Presea's emotional response is so subdued? So she's just like Colette. If we leave Presea like this, what will happen to her? When the parasitic process is complete, she will die. That's horrible. Please save her. What did she ever do to you? Nothing. She hasn't done anything. She just matched in the compatibility test. You promised you're going to save her, right? Yes, I know. You didn't discriminate against half-elves. I'll keep my promise. Kate, are you sure? If you do that, you'll... A promise is a promise. Say Presea, speak to a dwarf named Altessa who lives deep in Galarakia Forest. There are dwarves in this world too? Yes, he and I participated in this experiment by the order of the Pope. She's not that pathetic old man again. Don't call him a pathetic old man. Oh my, that's unusual, a half-elf siding with the Pope. I'm not siding with him. Anyway, have Altessa repair Presea's key crest. Can't you fix it? To be honest, I can't even tell the difference between this and a normal key crest. Probably be faster to search for that dwarf Altessa. Then settle, shall we head for Galarakia Forest? Yeah, though could there be a connection between the Pope and the designs? I'm wondering about that too. I'm trying to remember how... Kate might be the Pope's daughter? Not totally sure. To be honest, this whole town is not really preserved well in my memory. I'll leave it like that. So I can also hit up the women in the library, but I just haven't before. Now, Galarakia Forest is right there. This is a spot I remember too damn well. There are some problems with my GameCube disc, and... Screw it, I'll worry about the monument later. And as a result, doing this segment is hell on my GameCube. But this is where the Sword Dancer appears for the second time. You'll see him later on. He will not be here if you did not fight him the first time. This place is creepy. It's dark. Colette, you're awfully cheery. Sorry. Oops, it's the Papal Knights. Zelos the Chosen, you are in the way of the Pope. I've known that since I was a kid. Then that makes things simple. It's time for you to die.
You're going down!
These aren't even the boss of the
Alright.
Well, they definitely paid out, so I have no objections there. We won, but what are we going to do now? What else? Before they bring in reinforcements? We'll get the heck out of here, but to where? Perhaps they'll test this place. Exactly. So this is where we find our final party member. And the EXP payout does get better. Now this should be the sunlight, if I remember correctly. Hey, it emits light. It's like a lamp. What do we use it for? The forest is dark, so there may be some plants that react strongly to light. Labyrinth Forest. The Garakia Forest used to be a normal forest a long time ago. Oh, really? But then, one day, a thief hid a stolen treasure deep in the forest. This is true, by the way. Treasure? What kind of treasure? It was a jewel worth several billion gold. So anyway, he slaughtered everyone who came to looking for it. It's horrible. Over time, the forest became stained with blood, transforming into a cursed place, haunted by the lingering resentment of the people killed here. Are you serious? You're just trying to scare us, right? Even now, when travelers enter the forest, the thief's ghost comes to kill them. And the ones he killed also seek to increase their numbers. Sheesh, not even 3-year-olds believe stories like that these days. But the thing is, that kind of makes sense on why the sword dancer would be here if he's supposed to be the ghost. Or the thief's ghost. Now, the other part of the story... Drain Charm. I don't remember that offhand. There is... He, being Zelos, mentioned that there... Like a... Oh! Okay, this thing has a charge. That's what the yellow bar is. So as I was trying to say, you can find the first of the devil arms here. There is one here, I don't know if you can get it quite yet, that's the thing. I think you can. Thing is, there are two of them that you can find. And once you find one, you can start getting the others. Thank you. This place is too damn big. I'm lost already. So has anything changed to indicate that I'm in a different area? Okay, right here is the devil arm. What's this thing? It won't open. It's sealed by some type of power. You shouldn't fiddle with it. I don't like the looks of it. So we can't get it yet. It sucks. Okay, that was really delayed. In case you're wondering, yes, I am actively trying to find the sword dancer. Ah, that's him. Fight, fight, fighting is everything. I remember my reason to exist. Strong one, fight me. No way. Be gone if it is not time yet. Did I really run past him, or did he appear when I walked back? Anyway, he is near the exit, so that means we're going to have our boss fight shortly. I'll pass. But that's our clue to swap Zelos out for Rain. I'll also put him in the fifth spot so I can access him more easily. Once again, they give you the Sorcerer's Ring station here, so you can get this when you come back. The sunlight, that is.
I hear something. Footsteps from far away.
I don't hear anything.
Colette still has her angel senses.
They're definitely footsteps. Also, the sound of clinking armor. There are lots of them. It's coming from that direction.
That can't be good. Altessa lives over there. Could it be more of the same guys from earlier?
I'll send Corinne out to scout.
That's the guy from the Meltokyo sewer!
Man, it's just one thing after another with the Pope. Am I really that much of a problem to him?
You're that much of a problem to everyone, Zelos.
I do not wish to fight you. I just want to speak with that girl.
With Presea?
You've got to be kidding! Or did you forget that you tried to kill us?
I cannot speak for any others. However, I, at least, never intended to take your lives. My orders were to retrieve a girl named Colette.
Me?
I will do you no harm. Presea is her name, correct? Please, let me speak with her. An X-Sphere? You are yet another victim?
Presea's in danger!
I don't know what the heck is going on, but we have to stop this guy!
We have no choice but to fight.
So, magic lens.
No way! Are you
they only have him identified as Connor.
See? Why don't you?
Damn, he went down
just
fast.
Just as I expected.
We got an elixir for our trouble of all things. 10 grade, I think that's the actual max you can get per one fight.
He sounds like he has reasons for his actions. Perhaps we should take him prisoner? I'm sure he has much to tell us.
Sheena, there were a lot of soldiers and they're all coming this way! Run away, quickly!
Looks like Colette was right.
All I can say is thank God that thing's not voiced by Sandy Fox. Mew gets annoying as things progress into this, I'm not gonna lie.
The footsteps keep getting louder.
Shouldn't we get out of here?
But the Papal Knights are waiting for us if we go back.
It looks like we have no choice. I'll take you to the village of Mizuho.
Whoa there, Sheena. Isn't Mizuho a hidden village, kept secret from outsiders?
But we'll be trapped from both sides if we don't do something. There's nothing we can do but take shelter in the village.
Okay. Please show us the way, Sheena.
He's zealous. Carry the big guy for us.
Me? You want me to carry this ogre by myself? Are you kidding me?
Here, I'll help. Zealous will have a hard time by himself.
Aw, you're so nice, Colette. We Chosens have to look out for each other, right?
Yeah. Oh, he's lighter than I thought. I can carry him myself.
Huh, I see.
Men are so useless these days.
Come on, we need to go.
Mizuho. Pretty boys die young. Where in Galrakia Forest is this Mizuho village? I can't tell you that. Be there soon anyway, so just be patient. I see you Mizuho people are as secretive as ever. It's to protect our unique culture. If you don't like it, you can wait in the forest. You've gotta be kidding! I'll pass on being left behind in the forest of death. The odds of surviving alone in Galrakia Forest, 25%. Ouch, don't say stuff like that, Presea. You'll be fine. You look like the type that just won't die. I'll second that. But you know what they say, the pretty boys die young. Incorrect usage detected, correction necessary. Presea. And the payouts are starting to get crappy again. So let's trigger this real quick. What's your fighting style called? Oh, I'm a Guardian user. I fight with special cards infused with powers. Guardian user, huh? When I first met you, I was surprised how you could fight with a piece of paper. When dwarves create accessories, they carve charms into them, right? It's similar to that. I see, so if I buy some paper and draw some charms on it, it won't work. It's a secret art. Darn. If you really want to learn it, you can become one of us. How do I do that? Like marrying. Okay. What? I just need to marry, right? If you want to, then. I just need to marry someone in your village, right? You're so insensitive. Anyway, here's Mizuho. Mystical Village, Mizuho. Kinda wonder if the mystical line is supposed to be a reference to Goemon, but I'm not totally sure.
Sheena, what is the meaning of this? How could you bring outsiders into the village?
So, quick trivia for you guys. If you're wondering what Orochi means, that guy's name, it's Snake.
I am prepared to accept my punishment. Inform the Vice Chief. I've brought the travelers from Silverant.
From Silverant? You are from the dying world of Silverant?
Well, except for me.
I see. Sheena, come with me. The rest of you, wait in front of the Chief's house.
We're going to learn about Bolt shortly.
Oh, he's awake.
Where am I?
You're our prisoner. Don't try anything funny.
I like to think that I'm smart enough not to start trouble when I don't understand the situation.
Can't believe she were an outsider, so I was bringing danger. Starting with all that way back with that Volt incident a long time ago. How beautiful. We mustn't. What? No, that's not right. Next you say, it's fine. Okay. So we can pretend she's unhappily married or something. And she does have the kid right there, which is even more messed up than normal. Hello, madam. The Chosen is even more interesting in person than what I've heard. Style, even love must be conducted in secret. I don't think I'm cut out to be a citizen of Mizuho. And that's a kid, man. That's really messed up. Customization, Kotetsu Shiden. I'm not gonna waste any of my grade on materials. I'd rather just buy something if it's worth getting. Lens, I need another 6 of these. Let's go ahead and grab a sheet. I have money to spare. Shuriken is staying where it is. Card of Lightning, Card of Wind. Like, I kind of want the Card of Lightning if I'm going to use her against Volt. And then Card of Wind, while this may deal more damage, the big thing is, I don't have anything else to do that. Water Spider. Now, we already have Undine. This won't help us against Celsius. So yeah, I'm just gonna get both. There it is.
The Vice Chief is ready to see you.
Travelers from Silverant, you may enter.
Now, I don't recognize what Tiga is supposed to mean. Or if that's supposed to be like, they're trying to say Tiger? Because they could just call him Tora or something like that instead.
Thank you.
Our leader, Chief Igaguri, is ill. I, the Vice Chief Tiga, shall speak on his behalf.
Okay, if that's Taiga, it's missing the first A.
Because Sheena failed to kill you, we, the people of Mizuho, now face persecution from the Tetheala royal family and the Church of Martell.
Is that true?
Yes, at least from what I've heard.
Now I have a question. People of Silverant, what do you plan to do in Tetheala, the land of your enemies?
I've been thinking about that for a long time. Someone asked me why I came all the way to Tetheala, what it is that I want to do. I want a world where everyone can have a normal life. I'm tired of people having to become sacrifices. I'm tired of discrimination. I'm tired of people becoming victims. I'm tired of it all.
You are an idealist. The worlds of Tetheala and Silverant flourish only by victimizing the other. So long as that structure remains the same, anything you say is mere sophistry.
Then we need to change that structure. This world was made by that Yggdrasil guy, right? If a human or elf built this, then we should be able to change it as well.
You speak like the hero, Mythos. He was a sublime idealist. He ended the ancient war by insisting there was a way for the two warring countries to coexist in peace. Are you saying you can become the next Mythos?
I'm not Mythos. I want to save the two worlds my way with the help of my friends.
I see. In other words, you aren't worried about following past methods. Well then, we shall search for a new path as well.
Vice Chief, do you mean...
Yes, we will use our information network to aid you. In return, when the path of prosperity for both worlds has been found, we wish to move our people to Silveront.
But I don't have any right to decide something like that.
There's plenty of land.
All we need is for you to aid us in our move.
Is everyone okay with us joining forces with the people of Mizuho?
If it will change the relationship of the two worlds.
Well, it doesn't sound like a bad deal.
Let's hurry up and decide so we can go rescue Presea.
As long as Tetheala is safe, I don't care what you guys do.
Okay then, it's settled. We're going to look for a way to change the two worlds. Let's work together.
Agreed. Then I hereby order Sheena to continue to accompany you. This time, however, not just as an observer, but as a representative. Make us proud.
Yes, sir.
But Taiga, you sure you want to turn the royals and the church against you like that?
How about if I ask you? Given a choice between the forces which wish to sacrifice one of the worlds and the force that wishes to preserve both worlds, which would you side with?
I'd like to say the one that's likely to win. But I suppose I'd want to help the side that wants to preserve both worlds.
Exactly. Now the first thing we shall do is devote all our resources to locating the Riards. Fortunately, it appears that Sheena attached a guardian to the Riards, so we should be able to locate them shortly.
Understood. Thank you for your help.
Is he for real?
Gentle Idealist title obtained. Been a while since we got one of those, huh?
What's your name?
Regal.
Regal, huh? I'm sorry, but we're gonna have to keep you prisoner for a bit longer.
Lloyd, how about letting Pops here fight too?
Even though he might betray us?
He has business with Presea, right? And he's not gonna try anything before he gets a chance to speak with her, you know?
Actually, that's not a bad idea.
Rain?
I don't know about this, but I won't make a fuss. I also started off as your enemy.
Well, will you fight alongside us for now?
All right. I swear upon my good name and these shackles that bind me, I shall not betray you.
If you do anything, even the slightest bit suspicious, I'll burn you to a crisp. Got it?
Well then, welcome to our group, Regal.
Now, Regal is unlike any of the other party members, and to show you why we have to look at his techs, he doesn't follow the 1-2-3 system. Instead, he has different sorts of combos. He can go from ground to mid-air to anti-air, I believe. This is his only level 3, which is just his shield. This is his equivalent of Guardian, Force Field, and so on. So, when you're doing the title fights in the arena, Regal was always the one who gave me the most trouble, because it's... he's so different. I mean, Rain is pretty odd, Genus is pretty weird too, because you have to do spell casting. But as long as you have the power on those two, you're pretty much fine. So this is hinting at Regal's background, if you get his personal scope. Now I don't know if this changes just by having it equipped, or if you actually have to have him as your active, but you buy cheaper and sell for more. That is one of the ways you can actually get large amounts of money in this game. So yeah, their prices were cut by 10%. Mizuho's Information Network. I hope they can find the Riards. Mizuho's Intelligence Network is nothing to sneeze at. They'll find them for sure. Yeah, I've heard some incredible stuff about the Mizuho Intelligence Network. Supposedly they know the location of all the treasures in Tetheala. You bet. When we really want to, there's nothing we can't find out. Sounds like a great thing to have on our side. I wonder if they could research the measurements of all the girls in Tethiala for me. You stupid Chosen. So as you can see, Zelos is clearly focused on the important things. But I remember the location of this Wonder Chef. I am the mysterious gourmet, the Wonder Chef, and I shall teach you the greatest recipe of Mizuho's 4,000-year history. Ramen. Just add hot water, right? Ramen requires three ingredients: panyan, black satay, and seaweed. So they're actually making the fresh stuff. They're all. So, neat trivia, there actually is, like, fresh ramen instead of all the instant stuff. But, on a serious note, I don't know if you can talk to the chief in here. In case you can see him on the cutscenes, he's right here in the corner. He's pretty much bedridden while he's on death's door. Small knight. Your name is Presea, correct? About your family. Hey, get away from her! I apologize. So you're her little knight. Don't make fun of me. I've got magic, you hear me? Genus? What is it? Don't worry, I'll protect you. He bears no hostility. There is no need for combat. Ah. Oh. Also, I have no need for your protection. Oh. 4-4 Genus, getting shot down is going to become a recurring theme. Chief Igaguri has been in a deep sleep ever since a certain incident, which you'll be learning about as we go into Sheena's background story. It's basically how Roki and I forgot his brother's name, it's Habi or something like that, which is also a word for snake. All correlates back to Vault. So reasons for shackles. Say, Regal, why do you keep those handcuffs on? These are the symbol of my crime. A crime symbolized by handcuffs? I know, you're a handcuff thief! Oh, that's not it? Then you ran around causing trouble by putting handcuffs on people? I'm sorry, I suppose I should have said it in a way that was easier to understand. Regal killed a person, which is why he wears those. He killed him with his bare damn hands. Seems the pursuers have left the forest. You should hurry. Alright, let's head for Altessa's place right away. I want to go home to my village. Alright, Ozette first then. Yes, Presea's parents are probably worried about her. We should head to Ozette. Yeah, Presea's parents are a bit of a spoiler, and it's probably one that we will not be reaching in this video, but... well, everything is frozen. I believe that's Ozette over there. I can't turn the camera anymore. What was the place we saw in passing? So let's grab the sunlight ring in case I need to open a passageway, but I don't think there is because there wasn't a recharge station here. Damn, is there a way over there? No! Just realized I forgot to equip Sheena's new weapon on her. So let's see. Oh, I have a card of lightning already. Well, that sucks. As for Regal, he fights with Greaves, basically shin guards. Since he killed someone with his bare hands, he only fights using his feet from here on out. I don't think that even changes in Symphonia 2, but... like with Graces and Systeria, I'm trying to do everything in my power to repress any sort of memory of the game. Ozette. The Quiescent Village. Yes, because that's not stalkerish in any way, Genus.
Huh? Yeah.
Hello, Princess. You're making me blush. Tofu. So, once again, new place, new Wonder Chef. Mysterious gourmet, the Wonder Chef. I shall teach you the recipe for the time-consuming dish known as tenderloin. Tenderloin requires three ingredients, some type of meat, tomato, and onion. Farewell. Now I believe I have half the recipes. Let's swap it back over to Genus. So ramen gives you a moderate amount of HP, tenderloin gives you a moderate amount of TP. And I believe the recipes down here are the big ones that do all sorts of fun stuff. Nope. Hello, my beloved. It's been a long time since I've been here. Well, if you give people snappers, can you really blame them? Jeez. Strange fellow. Presea left the party, so I can't see what's good and what isn't on her. And Regal can wear this? What? He could share armor with Genus. Yeah, I have the ribbon. What happens if I equip this? I lose out on a little bit of luck. Why would you buy the... The bracelet is better than the gloves.
Job awaits. Goodbye.
Only Presea can retrieve the sacred wood used in the ritual at the church. I'm quite pleased that she has finally returned.
That man, he's a half-elf.
He is? Now that you mention it, didn't we see him in Meltokyo too?
He's creepy.
I agree, but, I gotta say that I feel sorry for the guy. I mean, he has to deal with the fact that there are magnificent specimens of males around like me.
I'd say you two are on the same level.
Ouch.
I heard that, you little twerp.
At any rate, we should have a talk with Presea.
Yeah. Smell.
Look.
There's a reason they're not showing a face.
Oh my. How horrible.
What the? This is not cool.
How could this happen?
Most likely the effect of X-Fear's parasitism. Presea has no idea what's become of the person in that bed.
How could that?
Presea, are you not coming with us?
I must do my job.
Let's leave Presea here for now.
Here?
If we try to move her, she will just fight back. Let's go see Altessa by ourselves to ask him about repairing the keycrest.
Yeah.
Weird guest. That weird guest of Presea's. He was in Meltokyo too, wasn't he? Yeah, I have a bad feeling about this. I can sense the smell of blood on him. Let's hurry to Altessa's place. It's dangerously Presea with that man. So how do you sense a smell of blood? Don't you just smell the blood, or am I missing something? But yeah, I think that's her father in the bed, and as you may have guessed, he's dead and decomposing. Colette, are you alright? Yeah, I stumbled. I'm clumsy. Are you hurt? No, I'm fine, I'm fine. So I didn't actually mean to leave just yet. There is still one thing we need to do before we can leave. We have to go up on the high ground. You're all with her, aren't you? Her. Presea, you were with that monster. Don't call Presea a monster. What? She hasn't aged a day for the longest time. What are you talking about? That's not all. Even though her father is dead, she won't even make him a grave. She's a monster. Half-elves are nothing compared to her. Will you guys take that monster and get out of this village? I'll thank you for it. You won't regret it. How can you say that? Oh, so you're saying that a child that never grows up isn't weird? There's a reason why Presea is like that. I don't know what it is, but it doesn't change how freaky she is. I doubt you outsiders would understand. Outsiders. It's true that we didn't watch Presea stay young while everyone else grew old. But that's not Presea's fault. It's the same reason half-elves are persecuted. Yes, if half-elves could live apart from humans like the elves, things might be different. But half-elves have no choice but to live in human villages. And humans experience the difference in the passage of time, and are constantly reminded of the fact that they are different species. Let's save Presea. Nothing good can come out of it if she stays this way. So right there is the big revelation that Presea is older than she appears. I think she's something like 28 years old, and she looks like she's 12. Anyway, we have some time, so let's go to Altessa, and we'll probably put the break in the video before we actually get Presea for good. What a little hole in the wall. And I kind of mean that literally.
Who is it?
Excuse us. We've heard that there's a dwarf living here. Is there any chance we could see him?
You desire a meeting with Master Altessa. Please, come inside.
So as you may have guessed, this is a robot.
Who are you people?
When her next bubble comes up, I'll point something out.
My name is Lloyd. We've come in regards to Presea. We heard about you from Kate and Cyback.
Leave.
What?
I don't want anything more to do with that girl. Get out of here!
was that all about?
I apologize.
So if you notice, her bubble is in all caps. From time to time in Western works, that is how they will represent robots. Japanese has something similar where the robot will only use a single specific alphabet. I believe it's katakana, but I'm not totally sure, which is basically their equivalent of uppercase, like here.
The master does not want to get involved with Presea.
Why? He doesn't care if she dies?
It is not that. It is because the master regrets what he has done.
Then please, save Presea. All she needs is for her key crest to be fixed.
I do not know if that would truly be in her best interest.
Why? How could anything be worse than living in that cruel condition while waiting to die?
If you are that committed, then you should search for inhibitor ore.
Presea's key crest isn't made out of inhibitor ore?
Correct. Her crest is...
Tabitha, what are you doing? Get rid of them!
I apologize. I must return. Please come back again. I will attempt to persuade him.
Where can we find the inhibitor ore?
I've heard it's mined in the mountain range that extends between Altamira and the Ymir Forest. I would like to help if you're going to create a keycrest for Presea. I can lead you to the mine.
Just what is your relation to Presea anyway?
There is none.
Yet you sure seem concerned about her.
Well, either way, you haven't done anything suspicious so far. You're welcome to come along with us.
Inhibitor ore is found relatively near the surface of the X-Sphere mine. The mine I know of is across the sea from here, on the southern continent.
I think that's where Gnome is, but I'm not totally sure.
You said Altamira, right? That place is awesome! Let's stop by there on the way!
That's the resort town, if I remember correctly.
We don't have time to hang out at that gaudy resort.
The sea? We're going out to sea again?
Okay then, let's go!
Yeah, let's hurry.
By the way, this has been bugging me for a while now. Haven't we met somewhere before?
Maybe.
Fine, ignore me. Not very friendly, are ya?
Is Tabitha an angel? That Tabitha girl was a little strange, you know. Really? How should I put it? She reminds me of you, when you had lost your heart as part of the angel transformation. Perhaps it is because she did not engage in respiration. What? Are you saying she wasn't breathing? Are you serious? So it appeared. I suppose she could have undergone heavy training to breathe silently, but... Don't tell me she's an angel, too. Sure, let's run with that. She didn't seem like a bad person. Can't be too careful. So I can't remember how we get to Altamira, but I'm gonna go ahead and put the break in the video here. So I'm gonna run over to the inn, which is right here, and we'll pick up here next time. Okay, that's something. So until then,